skin, pink bandage.
Hey guys, what is up? Welcome back to the Acne Channel. It's Callie here, my face story on Instagram for those of you who don't know who I am. And today what I want to talk about is how to stop obsessing over your skin slash how to change your mindset, that sort of deal. So obviously, acne is a very stressful, sometimes embarrassing, psychologically, mind kind of disease. These are just some quick tips and tricks that can help you guys. They're really easy to implement. It's not like you have to go out of your way to do these things. You might just have to change your mindset a little tiny bit, but I feel like these things have really, really, truly helped me in the journey to clearing my skin. I think stress is one of the biggest factors for me. So, you know, you stress out about your skin, you break out, and then you break out because you stress out. So it's kind of a hard cycle to break, and I just wanna share some of the things that I feel like have really benefited me and my journey. We all have bad days. We all freak out about our skin occasionally. I think that's normal. It's good to feel those feelings, but you don't want to be freaking out about it 24/7 and have it occupying all of your headspace all the time, because that really stinks. One of my first tips for you guys is in the morning when you wake up, do not run to the mirror. I used to do this every day. I'd run to the mirror and I'd be like, do I have any new blemishes? Am I breaking out? What does my skin look like? How many cysts do I have? You know what I mean? So do not run to the mirror. Don't worry about it the first thing you do when you wake up. Just get out of bed, start your day, get ready like you normally would. Don't obsess about it and run to the mirror. Tip number one. Tip number two. So when you're doing your routine, a skincare routine or makeup routine or whatever, don't get this close to the mirror. Again, all about the mirrors. Because even if you have like one or two pimples, or even if you have blackheads, or even if you have scarring, if you're this close to the mirror, you're gonna start analyzing and nitpicking at every little thing. So I think for me, just sitting back far enough to, you know, it's kind of blurry, like you can't really see it that well, has actually helped me feel better about my skin. I think when you feel better, you look better, your energy's better. So that is one of the things that has helped me as well. Or, okay, so this could go both ways. You know, if you completely won't look at yourself in the mirror and avoid mirrors, start looking at yourself in the mirror. Or if you're obsessed with mirrors, try to stay away from them. Whichever one you are, it's usually vice versa, one or the other. Another thing I have found myself doing, like I told you guys before, I used to be really obsessed about it. I used to occupy my thoughts all the time. I'm talking like 24/7. I'd be like looking in the car constantly, like, did I just get a pimple? Like, am I breaking out? Like, my face feels funny? Like, what's going on? And obviously that's not good. So if you feel like it's starting to occupy your thoughts a lot, if you're worrying in class, if you're worrying when you're driving, if you're worrying at the gym, wherever you are, whatever you might be doing, and you're worrying about your skin, try to change your thought process. Try to stop thinking about it. Try to start focusing on something else. Focus on, you know, what sounds good for dinner tonight, or maybe looking up a new recipe, or maybe do you want to go plant something in a garden, or maybe read a new book. Like, just try to change the way you are thinking about it, and don't let it occupy your brain space so terribly much. Again, this is for people who are obsessing about it. If you're not obsessing about it, then don't listen to me. Of course, as always, don't compare your skin to others. We're all different. We're not robots, we're humans, and that is what makes life great. But our skin is all going to be different too. Some of us are gonna have acne, some of us won't. That doesn't mean that one person is better than the other. Don't try to aspire to be someone else. Just try to aspire to be the best you that you can be. I think really comparing your skin to other people's, you know, you don't know, maybe they went through a bad phase of acne too, or maybe they've never had a pimple in their life. You don't know their story, you don't know them. So just compare yourself to you, and that is all that matters, and realize that. The next thing is stop Googling things about your skin. Yes, Googling. I used to do this all the time, and I used to be like, oh, I drink coffee. Does coffee cause breakouts? Yes. Oh, I use a new product. Does this ingredient in this product cause breakouts? Yes. Oh, I ate a carb-heavy diet. Does that cause breakouts? Yes. Literally, I kid you not, probably no matter what you Google, it is going to say that it causes breakouts. So stop Googling, does X cause breakouts? Because chances are, the answer you're gonna get is yes. And if you do that, what I found myself doing, going down that path, was oh, I'm going to cut this out because it causes breakouts. I'm going to cut this out. 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 And then the next thing you know, I have a whole long list of things that I have to think about constantly and have to cut out constantly. And that's just adding more stress and more fuel to the fire, to the acne fire. So really try to stay off Google. Try not to Google every little thing and see if it's making you break out, because again, I guarantee you, if you Google does X cause acne, it is probably going to say yes. The next thing, try to stick to a one skincare routine for a while and not buy any new products. I used to be very guilty of this, of giving into new gimmicks, of not really letting my skincare, like giving it the full potential, or just using one new product at a time. Try to use your skin routine for a while without stressing, without worrying. Let it do its magic. Give it at least 3 months before you decide yes or no, because if you are constantly buying new products, you're gonna be like stressing your skin out with all the changes, and you're gonna be stressing yourself out, and you're probably gonna be stressing your wallet out with buying all these new products. So just give your skin routine enough time to make sure that it is either right for you or wrong for you. I would say, you know, 2 to 3 months again. Okay. And I think the biggest thing to all of this, to quit obsessing over your skin, is working on self-acceptance. I think all of us can work a little bit more on self-acceptance. Even if we think we're there, there's probably some things that you still need to work on. Or maybe you have bad days. I have bad days. I have acne meltdown breakdowns. Quite. Sometimes, like I'd say once every few months, I have an acne breakdown if I get a couple cysts. But just work on self-acceptance and realizing that you are not your skin and that you are much more than that. You are like everything you love, everything you've learned, like you are your being. Do you know what I mean? So work on accepting yourself for who you are and not putting so much emphasis on your skin, because at the end of the day, when everything's said and done, when we're off this earth, when our life is over, do you want that to be the main thing that you poured all of your focus into? Probably not. So just work on bettering yourself and learning from things and loving yourself and all of that jazz. So I guess these are my top tips. Yeah, I feel like these are the things that have really helped me. Obviously, it's not just not stressing. There are so many different things that go into clearing your skin, so many different factors and variables, and just realizing that you might get the occasional pimple, or it might not go away until you're like 80. So that's that. But yeah, self-acceptance. I think that's definitely a big one. And not worrying about other people's opinions too of yourself, because your opinion is the only one that matters. Well, not with everything, but of yourself. All right, guys, that is it. So if you like this video, if you feel like you thought these tips were helpful, make sure to comment, like, subscribe down below to the Acne channel, and I will see you next time. Bye. There's a hope that's waiting for you in the dark.